The official belief in the infallibility of reason, logic, and causality seemed to us senseless as the destruction of the world and the systematic elimination of every particle of human feeling. This was the reason why we were forced to look for something which would reestablish our humanity. What we needed to find was a balance between heaven and hell, a new unity combining chance and design.
Arp talks about it, that the Renaissance made us megalomaniacs, that we wanted to control everything. And he thinks of chance as being a law that goes beyond that. It's a bigger law. And that he would like to tie into chance as something which is bigger in this world, a bigger force in this world, than some sort of rational system.
As the story goes, Jean Arp, frustrated and dissatisfied by a drawing he was working on, ripped the paper into pieces and let them flutter to the ground. Surprisingly, he was struck by the expressive quality of the patterns they formed. It was an epiphany. Inspired by this revelation, Arp created a series of collages whose visual outcome was determined according to the laws of chance, or so he claimed.
Again, he simply tore out sort of rectangles of paper and then dropped them down below. But the one I've seen several of those. The one I have in mind is, first of all, the ground of it is a soft gray paper. And the squares are blue and then white or sort of a creamy white. And if you look at those squares, none of them overlap or touch. They all are separate. And some of them fall in sort of vertical columns, and sometimes there's a suggestion of horizontal coordination. And you look at that, and I say, damn, he's one hell of a dropper. Or, now I immediately say, well, maybe he dropped those 200 times, and finally somewhere he got one that he liked and kept that one. Or maybe he only dropped them a few times, sort of got the hang of it, and so the problem, and then rearranged them the way he wanted. Under no circumstances would I accept that as something done purely by chance.
It was a big influence too for Tristan Tzara, who really appreciated this freedom. And he understood he could do the same in literature, because literature was a more dogmatic field than painting.
To make a Dadaist poem, take a newspaper, take some scissors, choose from this paper an article the length you want to make your poem. Cut out the article. Next, carefully cut out each of the words that make up this article and put them all in a bag. Shake gently. Next, take out each cutting, one after the other. Copy conscientiously in the order in which they left the bag. The poem will resemble you. And there you are, an infinitely original author of charming sensibility, even though unappreciated by the vulgar herd.